Hey, I'm Chandra, and I'm from a channel called Strawberry Moon, and I do like reaction videos and stuff.
Okay. I had to stop.
And I thought I would try Vlogmas. I don't know how that's gonna go. I don't know if I can commit to every day, but I was thinking about trying. Because I have a lot going on this month, and I especially have a holiday party coming up in a couple weeks, so I have so much to do. Like, I need to put knobs on cabinets that, you know, don't have knobs. And I gotta repaint my kitchen cabinets, and I have a laundry room that I need to spackle, paint, and put shelves up in. It looks awful. This is a bird aviary that attaches to my living room window that I built myself. And I will go show you the birds in a second. But they don't come in the window box a lot. They love being outside, even in the cold weather, which is surprising because I have tropical birds. And they just don't use their... It's like a nesting box that gets heat from my living room, and it has a little tunnel that goes outside into their larger aviary. And they hardly ever come in here, but they do come in and whistle and talk and stuff sometimes. And I know they have a warm space. So let's go see the birds, and then I'll tell you more.
Oh, this is Shadow. This is the best girl, Shadow. Oh yes, there's the best girl. Yes, what a good dog her is. This is the other best girl, Pup-Pup. For such a good dog. Yes, they're such good dogs.
This is the bird aviary. This one is Tilly. And then this one I just call Beady Bird. And in the background is two little parakeets. And honestly, I never named them. And I come out here every day and I just spend time with them. That's my living room window that the aviary attaches to. I just come spend time with them and I, you know, give them affections and feed them and give them water, play with them a little bit. Because they are, you know, cockatiels are the best little birds. They're very inquisitive. They're like little three-year-olds just getting into trouble all the time. I'm gonna try, I don't know how much video I can get of me filling their seed and water bowls. Cause I got like one, you know, two hands. I was trying to count my hands and it wasn't coming out. Okay. So little birds are going up for the night. This is their cage that's next to their nesting box. There's a little tunnel. I don't know if you can see it. The little tunnel is back here. But they have nests in here also. They just prefer to be out here in the open air cage than they do in the nesting box most of the time, unless it's really cold. And they have food and water in both cages.
What's Shadow doing? What's a Shaddy doing? Yes. What good girl you are. Yes, wants to go inside with Mama.
Now, before it gets dark, I need to go outside to my shed, which is in the backyard. And I really need to get some handles for this cabinet that's in the living room because I want it to look nice during my Christmas party. It's this cabinet with these handles right there. It has one knob, but I didn't like it in the first place. And so I want to get two knobs and put it on there. And this is all stuff I have. It's like stuff I've been piling in a corner. And I just need to organize it, throw half of it away, give some to Goodwill. So that's what I'm going to be doing today, probably. So let's go to the shed and get some knobs. So that is my shed up on the hill back there. And as you can see, I'm in beautiful Kentucky. I have woods up behind my house. There's a tree. There's a house back there. But during the spring and summer, you can't even see that house back there. It's just woods. We see so many deer here. You wouldn't think it because I live kind of close to town. Like town. I live in the city. But we're in Kentucky. Woods run through all through the town. So anyways, where's my shed? There's my shed. I hope I got the right key. Does everybody just have a million keys? I don't even know what they all go to, but I have 100,000 keys. But I think I got the right one. I'm going up to the shed. Okay. have a whole big lot in my shed right now. We're in the process of cleaning out our house. We're in the process of cleaning out our house from so much junk. And this shed, I'm sure, is going to be full eventually. Oh, walking a foothill.
Okay, here's my tool chest.
It's a wreck right now. So I keep a lot of main tools that I may need in the house, like a drill, screwdrivers, a wrench, like just pliers, just things you might need around the house every time you don't want to run up to the shed. But I put a lot of my painting stuff up here and my knobs for cabinets and just all kinds of stuff. I gotta try and find the knobs. Okay, I'm back in the house. I got some different options. These are the cabinets. What I'm gonna be doing with the cabinets is those orange spots on the middle of the cabinets is where I've already filled in the previous holes that were in the cabinet doors. And I'm gonna take those knobs out of the middle and drill holes on like the side corner, you know, like, I don't know, make it look better. But I've got to take those knobs out, fill those holes, drill new holes, and then put the knobs where they go, and also paint all the cabinets. And I'm wanting to do that soon also. But don't look at my dishes. It's my tiny little kitchen. Okay, so I got knobs. Let's go look at them. Okay, let's look at these knob options.
Okay, I wanted these black ones to work, because I think they're pretty and they got these little copper accents. And then I've got these ones. They're mismatched, but they all are. Like, they come in a package where none of them match because people just like these designs. You can get them on Amazon, ceramic knobs. And I've got these silver ones. And I'm going to be seeing which ones I think look just best on the cabinet, you know. And then we're going to put one on.
Okay, I'm going to hold each one up to the camera. Tell me what you think. You might decide something different than me. Okay. We got that one. I like that more than I thought I would. We got the silver one. My living room is more gold, like golden tones and natural woods and stuff like that. So, probably not the silver. Or these black ones with the copper accents. Let's see. I think I'm surprised, but I think I'm going for these ones. Let me give you a little close up. I need more light in here for sure. For show. Okay, the only problem is these are really big knobs. I think they're 1.5 inch diameter. So will they fit side by side without knocking into each other? I think they're gonna. Okay, that's a good look. Okay, so I'm gonna put these knobs in. Don't look in this cabinet. So what this cabinet is, it's funny because I feel like this is so introductory. Let me grab some and show you. I make coin rings and bells, and like this is made out of dollar coins. Can you see? And this one's made out of quarters. These are necklace pendants that I'm doing right now for Christmas for people. This one's made out of pennies. These are just little pendant balls that I'm doing right now. This is a ring made out of a quarter. I'll try and, you can't see the super, like you can't see the quarter details on it very good right here in this lighting. But I'll pop up a little picture of what quarter rings look like. But this is my cabinet that has my press in it and all my tools that I use to do that. And I keep them in my living room because I don't have a craft room. We only have a 2-bedroom house. And my husband, we don't have any children or anything. And so my husband uses the 2nd bedroom. He works from home and that's his office. So Okay. So, while I'm putting these knobs on, I wanted to talk to y'all about something. Oh, I feel like there's no light in here. Oh, that sucks. I do have a light over here I can turn on. Let me try. Hold on. That's a little better. I wonder if you can see the quarter ring now. Looks like the video is not showing details very well. But I also make bells, and a lot of motorcycles put them on their bikes as like good luck charms and stuff. Okay, and I also make leather jewelry. You're gonna see me making leather crafts also. Leather earrings, leather pendants, stuff like that. Oh no, dropped a screw. Got it. Okay, here's something I want to talk to y'all. I've been watching Colleen Ballinger for like 7 years. And if y'all don't know who she is, she has a YouTube channel called Miranda Sings. And I believe that's how she first rose to fame. And she toured all over the world with this character, Miranda Sings. And then her vlog channel got really big because when she had some pregnancies that were hard. But she also has a Netflix special. She's very talented, super talented. And she's a comedian and a singer, a classically trained singer. So, I've been watching her for like 7 years, watched her have all three of her children. And I didn't really watch Miranda Sings, I just watched like her vlog channel. Well, some huge controversy hit this year. A lot came out, and on my reaction channel, I actually made a video about it, about what the things that she got canceled for. And one of them was, if you know who Trisha Paytas is a sex worker, and she has OnlyFans and stuff like that, and different pornography. And she was making fun of Trisha because she's a plus size porn worker, sex worker. Was making fun of her to people and had almost like a viewing party of some of the pornography and sent a video of it to a 14-year-old. And I don't want to say allegedly because, I mean, it's all been confirmed. Like, as far as, I think I legally have to say allegedly, but as far as I know, Trisha confirmed it with the kid, who is now like, I think 20, but when he was 14 is when it happened. And then also Colleen apologized to her, which confirmed it also. So, I mean, it was a bad deal. And that's, is that the worst? How'd I go over all this that happened this summer? Other than the actual charges of grooming that was against her publicly, and then showing the pornography and just kind of being just a general crappy human in her real life and her private life, not her video life, you know, her YouTube life. She got canceled for all those things, but she came back just like 3-4 days ago, I think. And I watched a couple videos and then I felt guilty for watching a couple videos. Because, you know, the sick voyeuristic pleasure that we all get through YouTube. I wanted to see what she was going to say. Like, I just did. And she hasn't addressed it. Like, there's been no apology except for the apology video, which was like her playing a ukulele. Like, that really made the rounds. You should check that out. No, don't. She gets money from it. See, this is what I want to talk about. I have so many conflicting emotions. Because I watched her for like 7 years. It was like a habit. I feel like I know that woman inside and out in a lot of ways. And then you find out all these horrible things. And then they come back. And then they're basically entertainment. But you don't want to give money to someone that you genuinely feel has been doing really horrible things. I don't know. I guess I shouldn't watch her. And if she does come back, I can't believe she didn't address it more. Like I watched a couple of her vlogs and she talks about, you know, I had a hard time this summer and I was depressed this summer and I've been in therapy. But then she just goes on la la la, baking cookies and just being herself and doing the same thing she always did before. And you get the feeling she didn't care. Like, I think she cared that she got canceled and wasn't getting to tour and do all the things that she was doing. But you didn't get the feeling she actually felt bad about the reason she got canceled. Uh-oh. Is this stuck? And I don't know if I want to follow just generally crappy people. And I know some people in the entertainment industry can be very interesting, talented people, but not be good people. But because they're the talent, basically, what are you going to watch if you only watch stuff by good people? One, how would you vet it? And two, they might be more boring. Sometimes the crazy people are more interesting. Which, you know, I'm on here vlogging, so let's see how crazy I am. But, so she's back. And I don't know how I feel about everything. I wish if she had been more contrite, if there had been real apologies, if she had actually addressed the things that were going on, would I feel different? I don't know. Because what she did was so egregious. Is that something you should cancel someone forever for? The grooming of children, the manipulation of children, the sexual conversations she was having with children. Because not only did she show pornography to a 14-year-old, there are confirmed like text chats, because she was in these chat rooms with all these kids that were her fans. And it looks like she was having very serious sexual conversations with them about her ex-husband's penis size, all kinds of stuff. So, you don't want to give crappy people a platform. I don't know. Well, let's take a look here. Okay, so it definitely, where they're so large, you can kind of see where they're, the size, like, it tilts a little bit because the door is a little bit off. So what am I going to do about that? One, something's got to give. Two, something's got to give. Three, something's got to give. There we go. They each looked a little tilted. It's because the back of the ceramic knobs are uneven. Okay, so I guess that was a pretty decent introduction to me and what the vlog channel will be like. I pretty much have to clean or do some kind of project every single day. And I like to talk about things that, you know, are going on in the world. Not probably like Israel and Palestine, like, let's not talk about that, but stuff like, you know, YouTube and Colleen Ballinger, that's what really fills us in. So, it was nice to meet you, and this is Strawberry Moon Vlogs. Oh. And so the reason I call myself Strawberry Moon, I was looking for something for my reaction channel. And my favorite fruit is a strawberry. I was born in June, right when strawberries are delicious. And my mother went into birth with me while eating strawberry shortcake on her birthday. And so it's just, and every year for our birthdays, we celebrate them together and we eat strawberry shortcake. And it's a whole thing. So strawberries. But my name is Chandra. Which, my mom read in a baby book and it meant she outshines the stars, which the moon is larger than all the stars. And also, it turns out, we didn't know this till later, till my best friend married an Indian, Chandra is a very common surname over there. And, it's either usually used for males or as a last name. And, but it basically means moon. So that's how I ended up Strawberry Moon on my reaction channel. And then, so this is just Strawberry Moon vlogs. But I am Chandra, and this is me.
Rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop. Mistletoe home where you can see every couple tries to stop. Rocking around the Christmas tree, let the Christmas spirit ring.